Christopher Nolan's new film about Oppenheimer has sparked discussions. What do you think about discussing this important person? Julius Robert Oppenheimer, born on April 22, 1904 in New York, was a famous American physicist. He directed the Los Alamos lab during the atomic bomb's development 1943-45 and the Institute for Advanced Study in Princeton 1947-66. Accused of disloyalty, he lost his security clearance and advisory role in the US government. His case sparked debate about scientists' role in politics due to its impact on science and moral issues. Oppenheimer was the first to suggest the idea of black holes. He was a dedicated learner, always curious about science. After getting into astrophysics through his friend Richard Tolman, he wrote articles about imaginary space objects. These writings had mass about white dwarfs, meaning dense shining leftovers of dead stars, and neutron stars' theoretical Way limit, meaning dense leftovers from exploring stars. In 1939, Oppenheimer predicted something important. With Hartland Snyder, who later became his student, they wrote about gravity squeezing, suggesting there could be dying stars in space with gravity stronger than their energy. At first, few paid attention to his paper, but later, scientists realized that he foresaw black holes. Einstein called him a fool. Oppenheimer learned from Einstein. His remarkable intelligence and strong learning ability couldn't overcome his emotional immaturity and lack of political experience. One instance was his disagreement with Albert Einstein during McCarthyism's Fear of Communism. After meeting Einstein at Princeton's Institute for Advanced Study, Oppenheimer discussed his efforts to keep his security clearance with a colleague. Einstein advised him to step back from tough inquiries by the Atomic Energy Commission. However, Oppenheimer wanted to stay in Washington and fight for his rights. He lost the battle and faced lifelong consequences. After their talk, Einstein told his secretary, "He is a fool in every sense." Now it's time for you to face the consequences of your achievement. In the last scene of the movie Oppenheimer, Albert Einstein, a well-known physicist, says this sentence to an American scientist. The movie narrates the life of J. Robert Oppenheimer, renowned as the father of the atomic bomb, who headed the Manhattan Project in the 1940s. This project had the task of developing the very first nuclear bomb for the United States. He had a strong interest in humanities and was proficient in six languages, including Sanskrit. He read various books outside his field of expertise, such as Karl Marx's three-volume Capital during a three-day trip to New York and Marcel Proust's In Search of Lost Time to help with his depression. He learned Sanskrit to read the Bhagavad Gita, a Hindu sacred text. After witnessing the atomic bomb test, he recalled a line from the Bhagavad Gita where Vishnu persuades a prince to fulfill his duties. He said, "I am become death, the destroyer of worlds." At 12, he was accidentally invited to speak at the New York Mineralogical Society. He got interested in crystals and light at age 7, became a keen mineral collector and corresponded with local geologists on a family typewriter. Unaware of his age, a geologist invited him to speak. He hesitated, but his father encouraged him. Though surprised, attendees provided a box so he could reach the podium. Oppenheimer gave his speech and received audience encouragement. Students were fascinated by Oppenheimer. Oppenheimer, a friendly physicist, used both words and math to understand and describe the world. His speaking skills and expertise beyond physics made him an engaging speaker. He was skilled at crafting captivating sentences. Some students even imitated his appearance and behavior. He usually wore a gray suit, black shoes, and smoked Chesterfield cigarettes. He was nominated for the Nobel Prize 3 times. 18 of his colleagues at Los Alamos later won the Nobel Prize. Although nominated for the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1946, 1951, and 1967, he never won it. In 1963, he declined the Enrico Fermi Award for his significant role in atomic energy. He possibly tried to poison his professor with an apple. While getting his PhD in physics at the Cavendish Lab in Cambridge, England, Oppenheimer had tough times. Deep depression resulted from mental struggles and loneliness. His professor Patrick Maynard Stuart Blackett was a skilled physicist that Oppenheimer envied. Despite knowing Oppenheimer struggled with experiments, Blackett guided him. Oppenheimer's repeated lab failures and inability to impress Blackett increased his stress. Fueled by envy, he might have acted excessively. Francis Ferguson, a friend, claimed Oppenheimer confessed to poisoning an apple and placing it on Blackett's desk. But only Ferguson's claim backs this. Oppenheimer's grandson Charles strongly disagrees. Even if a poisoned apple existed, Blackett didn't eat it. Oppenheimer risked expulsion and charges, but his father's help saved his studies. President Truman famously referred to Oppenheimer as a crybaby scientist. Despite Oppenheimer's typically composed demeanor, he found it difficult to manage stress and pressure. In the aftermath of the atomic bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, he met with Truman to discuss nuclear-related apprehensions. However, Truman appeared to dismiss his concerns. Following this interaction, Oppenheimer made a frustrated remark about having blood on his hands, which didn't sit well with Truman. This led to a heated exchange between them, culminating in an abrupt conclusion to their meeting. Truman's displeasure with Oppenheimer lingered as he later expressed his negative sentiments about him to his Secretary of State. In 1946, Truman acknowledged Oppenheimer's pivotal role by referring to him as the father of the atomic bomb. He also recounted their meeting where Oppenheimer had conveyed his worries about the potential consequences of atomic energy. This encounter further emphasized the complex dynamics between Oppenheimer and Truman in the context of nuclear developments. J. Robert Oppenheimer chose the name Trinity for the first atomic bomb test, which was a homage to his former lover who had passed away. He crossed paths with Jean Tatlock in 1936, and their romantic involvement endured even during his marriage. Tatlock's affiliation with the Communist Party drew the attention of the FBI, leading to surveillance of their activities due to their political beliefs. Tragically, Tatlock's life came to an end in 1944. While officially ruled a suicide, there are conspiracy theories casting doubt on this explanation. Jean Tatlock introduced Oppenheimer to the poetry of John Donne, which held great meaning for both of them. The codename Trinity, given to the first atomic bomb test, was inspired by a line from Donne's poem, "Batter My Heart, 3% God." The FBI's monitoring of Oppenheimer and Tatlock came to light during Oppenheimer's security clearance hearing in 1954. This hearing, held by the Atomic Energy Commission, uncovered their connection and brought forth allegations of Oppenheimer's communist leanings. As a result, his security clearance was revoked, marking a pivotal moment in his life. This event led him into the spotlight of the McCarthyism era, a period marked by anti-communist sentiments and investigations. It seemed like the smartest minds in the world had expressed their hope that the atomic test wouldn't bring an end to life on Earth. What questions have occupied your mind and made you curious about? What topics or subjects are you particularly eager to explore? Share your thoughts and interests in the comments below.